What if I told you history could be made? Led by seniors Andrew Yoder and Norman Miller, the 2015-16 Westview Warriors won their 18th sectional championship in dramatic fashion. Now what if I told you history could be repeated? What once was the most inexperienced team in Michiana is now one of the most dangerous, as senior leader Lucas Yoder looks to lead the Warriors to another sectional crown and beyond. Determination, excellence, tradition, history. This is Westview Warrior Basketball.
Westview Warrior Basketball is streaming live on the World Wide Web at LaGuanaMedia.com. Today's game is brought to you by the following gold sponsors: Rigsecker Marketplace, Height Auto Body, LaGuana, and Shipshe Service. Silver sponsors are Topeka Do It Best Hardware, Topeka Pharmacy, Weaver Furniture, Jerry's Standard, Yoder Popcorn, Mike's Automotive Service, Fruit May Funeral Home, The Brethren Retreat, The Hometown Treasure, Yoder Insurance, Quality Floor, Fast Lane Subway, Frontline Auto Tech, By Tiffany's Restaurant, Yoder's Shipshawana Hardware, Troyer's Saddlery, Emma Warehouse, and Mercury Wireless. Our individual sponsors are Tim and Donna Height, Jim and Liz Stump, Dan and Dawn Byler, and John and Leslie Cook. Now, out to the game.
And welcome back to Westview High School for game two of the doubleheader tonight. It's the Westview boys and the Fairfield boys going at it. An exciting finish to the girls game, which just finished up about a half hour ago. And the Lady Warriors were victorious over the Fairfield Lady Falcons, 45-43. And now the girls go to 10-9 on season and 6-4 in the Northeast Corner Conference, and Brody Garber's Falcons drop to 11-8 and 6-4 in the conference. So now we've got the boys, Jerry Hosteller with Jamie Miller, to bring you this broadcast here tonight. Rob Yoder comes in with an 8-5 record, 4-1 in the Northeast Corner Conference. Troy Beachy's Fairfield Falcons are 7-4 overall and 4-1 also in the Northeast Corner Conference. Jamie, it should be a pretty good matchup tonight, and you had a chance to talk to Coach Yoder while the girls game was going on, so we'll be back with that interview of Coach Yoder right after this timeout.
There's just one place where students are students first and athletics are played with purpose and perspective. There's just one place where a team is more than a group of individual agendas. It's a catalyst for demonstrating the potential of the collaborative spirit. There's just one place where players, coaches, and fans experience the exhilaration that happens when an entire community rallies behind the school team. That place is your local high school. High school sports offer more than the joy of competition. Studies show that student athletes are more likely to enjoy greater levels of achievement in other areas of their lives, including academics. In addition, high school sports help young people in Indiana develop the discipline and confidence they need to be leaders in life, even as they unite communities like nothing else. High school sports, a winning part of a complete education. This message presented by the Indiana High School Athletic Association and the Indiana Interscholastic Athletic Administrators Association.
Okay, we're back at Westview High School. Both teams out on the court getting in their pregame warm-ups, and Jamie is with Rob Yoder in the locker room, and we'll be right back with that interview in 30 seconds.
When you're turning your house into a home, your furniture plays a big part in the finished product. And you'll love the finished products at Weaver Furniture Sales in Shipshawana. Come see the Weaver family. They'll work with you to find a piece that meets your needs or have it custom built just for you. Weaver Furniture Sales is located just south of 5 and 20 in Shipshawana. Or visit their website at weaverfurnituresales.com.
This is Jamie Miller here with LaGuana Media with an interview with Rob Yoder before the Fairfield game. And Coach, you've had some ups and downs this season and played some tough teams, and we got a great chance tonight against a good Fairfield team with a big crowd out there. And what are some things you're seeing from your team as far as improvement over the last few weeks that you'd like to share?
I think that we're getting more determined defensively. I think that we're one-on-one defensively, and then both and help side, I think, are improving. And I think our ball movement and screening is improving. I think those are two things on offense and two things on defense that we drastically needed to see improved. I think they've improved. And so you touch on the fact that our schedule's been very good, and I think that has made us better. It really shows your weaknesses long before you get to the sectional or the end of the year. You know they are. It gives you a chance to work on them. So we're really grateful for the schedule that we do get to play. And we realize sometimes you lose some games along the way when you do play that schedule. But I think overall, especially for as young as we are as a group and the quality of competition, I think we've really played overall pretty well and then found things that we really needed to work on and to get better. And I think we're getting better at it.
That's great. What about Fairfield tonight? What's their strengths? What do we have to look out for to try to stop to be successful tonight?
Well, Stevens is their best player, and he averages over 18 points a game. So he has the ability to drive the basketball, shoot the basketball off the dribble and on the catch from deep, and as well as pull-up jump shots. So he's a tough guard. So he immediately puts pressure on your defense. And then around him, they got good players. Miller is now a three-year starter, three years playing on the varsity. Good player, really solid, can score inside out. And then, so those are their two leading scorers. But then around those, they just have quality players that all can step up and shoot the basketball, all can make plays on both ends of the court. So we're going to have to play really well on both ends to have a chance.
Go get them, Coach. Thanks for your time.
Topeka Do It Best Hardware at the Blinker Light in Topeka is your authorized Maytag, Whirlpool, and Amana dealer. Topeka Do It Best has been selling appliances and providing service to the Topeka area for over 40 years. See JJ for your appliance parts. If they're not in stock, no problem. Topeka Do It Best will have them the next business day. Topeka Do It Best Hardware provides in-store repairs, and they make house calls. If it's worth doing, do it best. Call 593-2973.
And we're back at Westview High School. Both teams out on hardwood getting in their pregame warm-ups. Here we are, Jamie. Another great matchup between two pretty good basketball teams, the Fairfield Falcons and the Westview Warriors. We were maybe a little concerned when Fairfield went up a class and they aren't involved in our sectional anymore as far as the rivalry is concerned. But, boy, we always managed to fill up either the Fairfield gym or the Westview gym, depending on what year it is, with fans.
Yeah, this is really, I think this is our lead rival, you know, and the one that gets the most emotion involved on both sides. And it's great to see a full gym on a weekend. I mean, this is huge hysteria tonight, and not something you see every time anymore.
That's
and
right.
Really looking forward to tonight's matchup. Both teams have, you know, similar records. We're 8-5, they're 7-4. Fairfield has, they seem to play their best against good teams, and they've had some wins over some, a 9-win East Side team, and twice, beat them twice.
Wow.
And a 9-win East Noble team, a team that we weren't able to beat. So they, and they just lost, the NECC final last weekend in overtime to Angola in a game that they had won. And so I'm sure that's weighing on their mind, and they'll be on this home on this court, as a matter of fact. So I think that gives them a little advantage. They've been here. They're used to the rims. They're used to the you know, backdrops and things like that. So I'm looking for a great game, lots of emotion, and fan support here tonight.
Well, I think the players, and you could attest to this too, I think like to play in front of a crowd that's a big crowd like this, and makes it more exciting.
Yeah, that's what I've told my I kind of use as a recruiting tool when I was coming up and my boys were growing up. Other sports are fine and they're fun and everything, but would you rather play in front of 50 people or 2,000 people
yeah.
or 3,000 people? So absolutely right there, and it's going to bring out the best in both teams, I believe.
Pretty evenly matched. As you mentioned, their records are pretty similar. Fairfield, of course, now a 3A team. Westview still a 2A team, and I tell you, they're involved in a tough sectional down there at Northwood. So, right?
They yeah, played in that I believe Northwood that's sectional Northwood sectional.
Now, so, yeah.
Yeah, they're, I'm glad we still get to play them in the NECC tournament, you know, occasionally
right.
and at home, or, you know, regular season, because you really miss the Fairfield-Westview sectional matchups.
That's right.
Because that was where a lot of this rivalry came from, and a lot of the good memories and bad. For both
definitely.
Sides.
Definitely. Yeah, and you mentioned Fairfield coming off a tough loss in that final last Saturday night right here. No, it was, that was
yeah,
here.
It was
Westview.
Right here.
Tough match or tough game for the Falcons to lose, so they're going to be ready to bounce back tonight. A little bit of extra incentive there to get a win. And the Warriors, of course, they had to be disappointed with their showing in the NECC, get knocked off right away by Angola, who they were really looking to knock off to avenge that loss over at Angola earlier. So it's been a long layoff for us. Be interesting to see how the kids bounce back. I'm sure they're ready to play instead
yeah.
of practice.
We've always, you know, I guess looking at the history of the NECC and what you do after, it kind of, the week or two after you play the NECC, it kind of seems to be when the team really starts gelling and coming together, and that's kind of what you're going to have, you know, for the rest of the year. And I look for some improvement. I think we're going to see better ball movement and maybe a little more scoring and just some of the little things that are have been the difference between winning and losing this year, because we haven't been blown out. We've just lost several close games to tough teams.
Well, last year, you know, it was kind of a surprise that we made it to the made it through the sectional last year and a berth in a regional, but our team did start to gel close after the NECC down, and then, you know, once it got down the stretch, we
yeah.
kind of peaked at the right time. So
it seems like they kind of grow up over Christmas break and the next week or two, and it just a little development and maturity and in all aspects. And so we're looking
right.
forward to it. We're currently we're ranked 10th in 2A with the Sagarin ratings yet, which is still pretty high for the record that we have.
Really?
But I think that reflects some of our schedule strength, playing 3A and 4A schools, while Fairfield is currently ranked 41st in 3A. So I would think that would be a little low from what I would have expected, but, you know, 3A's, they are bigger schools and better teams in general. So one quick stat here. During Rob's tenure, and this is his 14th year, he is 14-7 against Fairfield. So, and we lost, I think, three out of the first four when he took over.
Really?
So since then, he's 13-4 or something like that. And unfortunately, two of those were in the sectional championships, and I remember him distinctly.
Oh, I bet so, too.
But we've had pretty good success lately against him, so look to continue that tonight.
All right, and the both teams coming to their benches now, and we're getting set for the tip-off here in about a minute. We'll be back right after this for the boys' game.
Fever, sore throat, body aches? Yes, the flu season is here, so how do you protect yourself? Well, talk to the friendly pharmacists at Topeka Pharmacy about getting a flu shot. They're free with most insurance plans. No insurance? Pay $32 for the regular dose or $60 for the senior dose, and you'll receive a $5 gift card for your next visit. No appointment needed and no prescription needed for those 11 years and older. Many other immunizations are available. Call 260-593-2252 or stop by Topeka Pharmacy in downtown Topeka.
And we're back. Let's take a look at tonight's starting lineups for tonight's game. First of all, for the Fairfield Falcons, Ryan Deere, 5'11 sophomore, along with Jake Oberlin, familiar name. Also Brady Willard. He's the son of Westview teacher, Gina Willard. Teaches at Meadowview. Didn't catch the last one. It had to be Shandon Miller.
Yeah, that's who it was.
Yep, Shandon Miller, a 6'2 junior. He's been playing since he was a freshman. And now for the Westview Warriors. They'll start, I would imagine, with the same lineup that we normally do. Charlie Yoder, 6'2 freshman, averaging 8.9 points per game. The other guard will be Elijah Hale, team's leading scorer, comes in to tonight's game with a 17.1 point per game average, and Elijah, 6'3 sophomore. Cody Collier is 6'4 sophomore, averaging 9.5 points per game, will be a one forward, and Josh Ostetler will join him on the other side at 6'1. He's a sophomore, averaging 5.5 points per game. And starting in the middle will be Nick Rensberger, a 6'4 sophomore, averaging 6.5 points per game. And we're ready to roll. Packed gym at Westview. I don't know whether we said that on the air or off the air, but it sure is good to see the gym full tonight.
Yeah, sure is. One little section has a little room if you're still out there and you want a seat, so come on in. But yeah, it's great to see people from the back wall to the floor.
And the traditional whistle coming from Dan Byler, which the Fairfield fans absolutely despise.
Especially at their place. They like to drown that out. But
yeah, that's true.
Can't do it here.
Cordell Hofer will jump center, and the tip is controlled by the Fairfield Falcons.
That's a good-looking sophomore there, number 12.
Yes, he is. He drives, puts it up, and he gets the roll.
Real athletic and long, and nice move there down the middle. Fairfield looks like they're coming out in kind of a 1-3-1 type of zone.
Josh Ostetler had Charlie cutting toward the basket, and so a little mix-up in communications there, so it's a turnover on the Warriors.
I wouldn't be terribly surprised that we've come out maybe a little bit rusty, but we haven't played in 10 days.
Yeah, Tuesday night, a week ago, Tuesday, so it's been a while. Or was that?
It would have been a Thursday, I think, we played the consolation, so I guess it hasn't been 10. It's been
eight. We played Hamilton, that's right. We didn't broadcast that game, and I didn't make it out for it, so it seems like we haven't played for even longer than that. The money is being exchanged here. I remember having kids, too, and they'd come up and tap me on the shoulder.
Now I'm getting hands reaching from all over.
There you go, yeah. Once you give money out, that's what happens.
Well, it's my daughter playing up in the band, and she's hungry.
There you go. Missed shot, but Cody Collier came down with a rebound. Charlie Yoder in the corner. Josh Ostetler, no good. Rebound is pulled down by Brady Willard.
Well, we're getting some good shots right away. It's good to see open 15-footers, but we'll start knocking them down soon.
Shandon Miller, he'll hand it off to Jake Oberle. Now out front is it. Munn or Degline, I don't have a 30 on my roster, but then maybe it is on yours. Is there a 30? No.
Yeah, I think they switched us up on numbers there.
Ball knocked out of bounds. It'll be Westview ball.
That was a little surprise half-court trap we pulled on him there, and it kind of surprised him. Knocked the ball, and then Elijah hustled down there, and I believe he reached through his leg and knocked it off his foot. So good hustle there by Elijah.
Westview a chance to tie or take the lead with a three. Hales. Bounce passes the right side to Charlie. Back to Hales, left side to Collier. Now to Charlie. Out front to Elijah. That's Josh. Yeah, what are they playing? 1-3-1, I guess, isn't it?
Yeah, they do a lot of mixing and matching of defenses, and so sometimes it's hard to figure out what's going on, but I think some of the same principles apply on beating it.
Collier misses, but Charlie with the offensive board. Now Josh, he'll give off to Charlie. Yoder drives a baseline, gets it out of trouble to Elijah. He has an open 15-footer and swishes it.
Shots just seem to go in more often when it's inside out, and that time Charlie drove baseline and threw it back out, and Elijah nailed it to break the ice.
Long three-pointer by Shandon Miller. He hits 5-2 now. Westview trails it by three.
Fairfield has the ability to throw in a bunch of threes, so we're going to have to stay out on them. Looks like they're extending it just a little bit here on their on the defensive end.
Collier comes out to help out. Josh Ostetler back to Cody. Left side to Elijah. Cody back to Elijah, now to Josh Ostetler. Usually, 5 minutes.
What you want to do here, Jerry, is get the ball in the middle like
there
they just did. And when you get it in the middle, it sucks the rest of the defense in and it opens up shots.
Ball tipped out of bounds. It'll stay in the possession of the Warriors.
You want to get it to a guy in there that can create off the dribble and is a good passer. So we have a lot of options in that category. So interesting to see who he flashes through there. Looks like we're running a set play here.
Elijah. Right side to Josh. Back to Elijah. He'll go to Rensberger, intended for Collier, I believe. Back to Josh. In the corner to Charlie. And inside to Nick Rensberger. Now to Josh Ostetler. To Collier. Jumper off the mark. Tipped out, chased down, grabbed by Fairfield. Driving all the way to the bucket and being fouled.
Elijah
by Hales,
went for the, yeah, he went for the jump ball that time, and they got calling for grabbing his arm instead.
So that'll be the first foul on the Warriors tonight. That goes against Elijah. Inbounding will be Shandon Miller.
I think it's going to be important tonight to try to get some transition baskets off of steals and missed shots instead of setting up against that 1-3-1 all the time.
Long three is off the mark, no good. Chased down by Nick Rensberger. It has it knocked away from behind by Shandon Miller. It'll belong to Westview.
Yeah, the intensity's up right now. You can see
it
him
is.
Going after the rebound. And we've played in so many games recently where every possession counts. And so we're really digging in on defense and trying to get a good shot on offense. The guys need to keep shooting there. They're getting good shots. They're going to go in. It's just a matter of percentages.
5-2. Westview trails it. Collier inside. Turnaround jumper is long. Rebound Rensberger. Good offensive board.
Well, they're all over him.
Wow, that could have been a foul.
Should have been a foul.
Willard gets it to Hofer, and we have a whistle and a foul.
Yeah, Josh just got run over by a train out there.
Man, he's hurting a little bit.
Yeah, let's see, who was that with that on the foul on?
Hofer.
Yeah, he was going full blast, and the thing you're taught is to stop the ball. And there's more than one way to do that, I guess.
And he did it the hard way. 5-2, Westview down three.
Well, I think that shows why he's in the game, too. He does those little things that don't show up on the scoreboard necessarily, but he's done.
Exactly. And we have a whistle underneath, some contact, and that's going to go against Hofer again, I believe.
Yeah, it's two on him. Fairfield, they have a good mix of young athletes and some experience out there. So that's it's usually a pretty good combination for success.
Gear comes in, a 5'11 sophomore. Bounce pass to Rensberger, now to Collier. Collier gets it to Charlie Yoder. He drives it, gives off to Josh. Charlie. Now to Hales. Hales drives it in, gives out to Charlie Yoder. He'll drive it into the lane, put it up, and miss a shot. Ball tipped out of bounds. Last touch by Josh Hostetler. It'll be Fairfield basketball.
Yeah, good drive by Charlie. Just we've come out a little cold. I think those shots are going to fall later in the game. We're getting better shots this game than we've got in the last two. Well, I didn't count the Hamilton game, but the last two that we've been on air.
Fairfield with the basketball, Shandon Miller. He's looking for help, tries to drive on Rensberger, picks up his dribble, gets it out front to Gegline. He drives, and we have a whistle and a foul's going to be called on Westview again under the basket.
That was a tough call there. That guy was out of control, and they bailed him out.
Another foul on Elijah. That'll be his second. 2:50 to go in the first quarter. The girls victorious earlier by 2, 45-43 over the Lady Falcons. Jeremiah coming in now for Elijah after picking up his second foul.
Yeah, that's a big loss with the guy that has the ball in his hands a good percentage of the time, but we got a good bench and I think we're going to see it.
Miller gets it inside, shot by Gegline's in and out and back in again.
They called basket interference
on
that.
Oh, okay, so no basket.
I didn't see anybody tip it.
No, maybe they touched the net. I mean, yeah.
Oh, in the net, okay.
Yep. So it's still 5-2. Westview trails it. Rensberger to Jeremiah. Hostetler, bounce pass to Cody. Now to Josh.
We need somebody that's going to step up and be confident out there and make some shots.
Kick by Miller. Westview will inbound it in front of the Fairfield bench. Troy Beachy in his sixth year at the helm of the Fairfield Falcons, right next to Josh as he inbounds it. 67-58 record for Beachy. Can't believe he's been there 6 years already.
Yeah.
Mima drives it and pulls it out. Cross court, Charlie for three. No good, short. Collier got way up in the air but couldn't grab it. Ball knocked away. Mima grabs it. Tries to get it to Rensberger. Down by his feet. He couldn't handle it. Shandon Miller quickly up the gear. He'll try to get it inside on the pass. Mima comes up with a tip. Charlie Yoder now will drive it. He'll put it up. And we have a foul before the shot. Didn't go in anyway.
Well, the fans got a little action there finally at least. No
That's
results,
true.
But we got a big crowd. We got to keep them in the game. 5-2 won't cut it. So
Willard picks up his first foul. Second foul, or fourth foul, rather, on Fairfield. Inbounding will be Mima. Jeremiah Hostetler gets it in to Josh, his brother. He misses the three-point attempt, almost tipped in. Shandon Miller comes up with it. He'll bring it up himself. In the corner to Gear. Gear, 5'11 sophomore. Inside, shots up, blocked by Charlie Yoder.
Good reaction that time by Charlie. Those long arms coming in handy again.
Munn tips it out of bounds. It'll be Westview ball right into the hands of Dean Christner.
See, what was it a couple of years ago that we struggled to, what was it, like 27-21 for the game with Fairfield?
That's right, it was. I forgot about that.
Kind of feel like we're headed that way again.
It seems like it.
I sure hope not, but.
Yeah, no, 7 points. We're only, a minute and 20 to go in the first quarter.
Yeah, I think both teams have good offensive players, and it's going to start showing here before long. Sometimes it gets a little helter-skelter. Guys loosen up a little and just play instead of think too much.
We're moving the ball pretty well. Mima caught with it, and he Crosses an interception, but it looked like Munn stopped on the, yeah, he stepped on the out-of-bounds line, so it'll be back Westview's way.
Russ Yoder giving some instruction to Charlie on where to go on the offense, showing him some openings, so we'll see what happens here on this end. Charlie needs to keep shooting. We know he's a good shooter, and he's going to hit him.
Inside a minute now to go in the first quarter. Westview down 3-5-2. Charlie Yoder. We get it to Jeremiah Hosteller. Now left to Josh Hosteller. Right back to Jeremiah. Inside, Charlie got open, and he puts it in.
I think that's what Russ was talking about. Once the ball reverses, the cut behind the defense there, and he was open for a backdoor feed.
Good recognition by Rusty. I'm sure that's what he saw.
We'll give him credit.
Yeah. Charlie made it happen. Fairfield will go for the last shot here in the quarter. 18 seconds left in the first quarter. Westview trails it by 1, 5-4. It's in the hands of Brady Willard. Driving, having it knocked away into the hands of Collier with 3 seconds. Charlie, I have a chance to get a shot off. He does, and he hits! Right at the buzzer. Good job by the young freshman. Was able to, you know, a lot of times a freshman like that will rush it, and he knew how much time he had, and he drove it right in, took the high percentage shot.
Yeah, it's a combination of factors there. Just some played a lot of games. He knew how much time he had, and he knew how long it took to get there. So great point there on that decision-making.
We played 8 minutes, and the Westview Warriors have taken the lead right at the buzzer, 6-5 over Fairfield. Back with second quarter action right after this.
Dale's Dependable Handyman Service provides handyman repairs and remodeling to the surrounding LaGrange County area, including Goshen, Middlebury, Albion, Kendallville, and Angola. If you're looking to update your kitchen, sometimes it's as simple as changing countertops and adding tile and glass backsplash. It can make your kitchen look brand new. Dale's Dependable Handyman Service, providing quality installation with quality materials. Call Dale at 260-336-9364.
And we're back. Jerry Hostetler with Jamie Miller. We're at Westview tonight in a jam-packed Westview gymnasium. A lot of media here tonight, a lot of fans here tonight. A lot of good basketball.
Just not a lot of scoring yet.
That's right, not a lot of scoring. 11 points on the board after the first quarter, and that's a total of 11 points. 6-4 Westview, 5 for Fairfield.
It's like Fairfield's maybe dropped into, they're not extending their 1-3-1 quite as far. Probably trying to protect the basket since they've given up 2 straight layups, but we're going to have to figure this out.
Jeremiah Hostetler still in the lineup. Elijah Hales on the bench with 2 fouls. Cody Collier down on the baseline to Charlie Yoder. Back to Jeremiah. Bounce pass to Collier. Now to Josh inside to Rensberger, and he's fouled from behind.
That's where we need to get the ball, and also Cody's getting it at the elbows, and that's his shot. So he's got to go up with that. You know, he's missed a couple of them, but he's a good shooter, and he's got to be confident.
Oberlin picks up his first foul for Fairfield. That's the team fifth. Ball knocked out of bounds by Munn. Zach Munn, a 5'11 senior. Jeremiah looking to trigger it in for the Warriors. And a ball deflected, but Nick couldn't hang on. It's deflected, and it looked like he had it for a while, but then it...
Defensive back hits it right before it gets to the wide receiver. It throws off their timing, and that's what happened that time, and he just couldn't corral it, and then they slapped it off his leg.
Brady Willard across the timeline. He'll work at left side to Jake Oberlin. He drives it into the lane. Now we have a scrum. Just about a tackle there, and we have a tie-up. I guess it's going to be a held ball. It'll stay in the possession of Fairfield.
Well, it's good to see the referees let them play a little bit. I think pretty much all the contact was right around the ball itself, and so that's why they let that go. That looked like my eighth grade game last night, the whole game.
And a football game instead of a basketball game.
Yeah, pretty much.
Jake Oberlin inbounding to Shandon Miller. An
Now they'll swing it around to Oberlin again. Driving down there is Hofer. Long three is good by Oberlin. 8-6 now. Fairfield has taken the lead. Charlie Yoder, Josh Hostetler, now Jeremiah Hostetler.
Fairfield has gone to more of a conventional 2-3 zone now, and they're going to stay in it until we can prove we can beat it and get ahead of them a little bit. And then I wouldn't be surprised to see them come out and play a little more man. But if it's working, why change it?
That's right. Charlie at the free throw line. He'll get it to Josh. Inside to Collier. Turnaround jump hook. No good. Tipped around. We have a whistle and a foul on Nick Rensberger inside. Made some contact with Cordell Hofer. That'll be foul number one on Nick.
Yeah, he slapped the ball away from behind, but they said he got him on the arm, I guess. So another good shot there for Cody, and just didn't fall. So important to get a stop here. We get too far behind, we may start questioning some things, but.
Hofer gets it to Munn. He'll drive, put it up. Short off the glass, rebound Charlie Yoder. Lead pass ahead to Collier. He'll give it to Elijah Hales, who's checked back in for Josh Hostetler. Driving, good runner by Charlie, but it wouldn't go. Then we have a foul on Fairfield.
Yeah, there seems to be a lid on the basket down at that end. But good drive. That's what we need. Perfect shot.
Foul was called on Shandon Miller. That'll be his first, or second, rather. Elijah Hales will inbound. Right in front of retired Westview teacher, Jim Miller. Biology teacher at Westview for many years. Driving and putting it up on the runners, Charlie Yoder.
That's about where he just missed it last one from. So he's finding the gaps in that zone, and that's exactly what we have to do. You got to dribble, penetrate, and either drive, draw two people and dish it off, or you drive all the way.
Munn cross-courts it into the corner to Oberlin. Now they'll get it back out front, Shandon Miller. He'll give off to Munn. Now back in the corner, Brady Willard. Willard swings it back out front now. Now Shandon Miller in the corner. Oberlin, quick touch pass inside of Munn. He fakes and travels with the basketball. Yeah.
Great defense that time. Fairfield did a good job of skipping the ball across both corners a few times. So we recovered and helped side and closeouts and didn't even let him get a shot off.
I think we're going to have to find out who number 30 is, because now 31's come in, and that must be Zach Munn.
Yeah, they're not matching our numbers at all.
So we're playing a guessing game out here, and it's not working out very well. 8-8, we're tied up. 4 minutes, 56 seconds to go in the first half. Jeremiah Hostetler. We'll get it to Charlie Yoder. Out of Nick Rensberger, back to Jeremiah. He'll go right side of Charlie. Charlie looking for help, gives it to Elijah. 4.5 minutes to go in a half. Westview looking for a high percentage shot here.
Coach is calling out something. The defensive, Fairfield's coach is calling something out on defense. So.
Oh, good pass inside to Elijah.
A little post-up action there, high-low, and we'll take him any way we can get him tonight.
Elijah snuck in there and got the bucket, his second of the game. He has 4, 10-8. Westview by 2, 3:58 to go in the first half. Willard drives the baseline, puts it up off the glass, too hard, no good, but we have a whistle. Another foul is going to be called on Nick Rensberger. I guess he pushed off on the attempted rebound.
Well, yeah, I think it was number 10 for Fairfield. I'm scared to say names because I'm not sure if they match up with the numbers or not, but looked like Willard went after the ball and Nick kind of clobbered him from behind. If you're going to get a foul, you might as well make it worthwhile.
I guess that'll be Nick's second. Fairfield will be inbounding underneath their own basket. Lob inside, Shandon Miller puts it up strong, too strong, goes over the rim, and Nick Rensberger comes up with it to Josh Hostetler. He'll put it up, oh, he misses, but he's fouled and he'll be shooting two.
Good job by Nick that time to give the ball up. He was leading the break and he realized that might have not been the best option for that break, so he gave it to Josh, who made a nice play.
Josh at the free throw line. Lucas Yoder is checked in for Charlie Yoder. Josh hits his first free throw and gets his first point of the night. 11-8 now, Westview by three. 3:43 to go in this first half. Second shot in the air, bounces off, no good. Rebound Miller for Fairfield. Driving, trying to get the pass off, tipped away and into the hands of Ryan Gear. He'll get it out front to Miller. Miller drives, fakes on Rensberger and pulls it back out front.
Coach calling for a push off on that one, but it was kind of borderline.
Miller for three from the left side, and it's good.
Yeah, you can tell he's a real experienced player, knows when to pick his spots, when a good shot's coming, and his experience is really showing.
That ties it up, 11-11, 2:55 to go in the half. Rensberger hands off to Elijah, Josh with a three, and he hits nothing but net.
That's good to see. He's missed a couple of them. It's nice to see him keep shooting. We need that.
So the Falcons and the Warriors exchange threes, and Westview back up three now. 14-11, 2:35 to go in the half. Miller, another three, it goes. Might have a war of threes tonight.
Yeah, he's going under the screen on those, and you can't give that up when you got a three-point shooter.
Collier holds out front, gives out to Lucas Yoder. Back out front to Elijah, 2:15 now to go in the first half.
Calling out a set here, I believe, to try to get something quick. If everybody gets where they're supposed to go.
Elijah. Inside pass to Collier, knocked away from behind, looked like he might have been fouled.
Yeah, he was.
came up right over his back.
Yeah, he was held.
Like you said, Jamie, they're letting him play. Inside pass. Turnaround jumpers, no good by Munn, but we're going to have a foul on Josh Hostetler.
Part of the thing with these two teams is Fairfield, I think they scout us about 20 times a year.
Yeah,
every
probably.
Year. Whether they play us or not.
Yeah, I see their coaches around.
They know our plays about as good as we do, I think.
Yeah.
And so there's not a lot open, and we just got to kind of make stuff happen out there.
True, good point. Inbounds pass comes to Miller. Shandon Miller tries to drive the baseline. Shot off by Lucas Yoder. He'll get it into the hands of Willard now. Minute and a half to go in the first half. Ball almost thrown away. Fairfield retains possession. Down the corner, Willard for three, and it's in and out. No good. Rebound Elijah.
He got fouled.
Hales tips off the hands of Fairfield, then off the hands of Josh, and it goes out of bounds. It'll be Fairfield basketball.
Seems like a high percentage draw passes tonight are getting tipped by Fairfield.
Right.
And that's a credit to them for being active on defense, but it's really tough to get anything accomplished when that's happening.
We had a good break going there, but a hand came in and deflected the basketball. 14-14, 64 seconds to go now in the first half. Hofer holds out front, gives off. Now to Munn. Driving and putting it up and good is the mystery player.
I think that's Stevens.
Oh, he's wearing 30 instead of
11.
That would make sense.
Yeah, I think I saw him earlier with that bandage or padding on his leg, and he was in a warm-up, had his name on the back. So I believe that would make sense. He's
yeah.
their leading scorer.
Exactly. He's their 18, a little over 18 points a game coming in tonight. 25 seconds, we're going to spread it out and try to take the last shot of the first half. Trailing by two, 16-14. We're down to 15 seconds now to go in the half.
You might want to start this play a little earlier. The players seem confused.
Yeah, they are. Josh,
we're down to eight.
Elijah back to Josh. Looks for the three, can't find it. Now Lucas, he'll pop it, and it's long, no good, and that'll do it. First half comes to an end. Fairfield with a two-point lead, 16-14, after 16 minutes of basketball in the boys' game tonight. We'll be back to take a look at halftime scoring right after this timeout. Oh, yeah, go ahead. Hey, we're going to wait. Are we still live, Justin? Okay, we're going to wait till after the performance of the Westview dance team. So enjoy. We won't make any commentary, right?
Probably best if we don't.
We'll, yep. By the talented Westview dance team. And we'll be back after this 30-second timeout. Jamie will bring you the game scoring and some stats.
And we're back at Westview High School for halftime of the Westview and Fairfield game. Fairfield currently leads 16-14. Fairfield is led tonight by Shandon Miller with 9 points, and he's got those on 3 three-pointers. And he hit a couple of them there toward the end of the second quarter when we were making a little run. Jake Oberlin, a 5'11 senior, has a three-pointer as well for 3 points. Cordell Hoffer has 2 points. He scored the first points of the game. And so he's got 2 points. And let's see, I think we got one more person here. Luke Stevens, number 30 tonight. Normally he's number 11, and he's got 2 points. He scored right before the half for his only basket. So we did a good job on him with his 18-point average. For Westview, we got Elijah Hales has 4 points. Charlie Yoder had 6. Josh Hostetler has 4. And that is it. So that equals 14 pretty quick. So we from the field, we only shot 6 for 17, which is obviously not a real high percentage, about 33-35% maybe. So a lot of shots we normally hit. Fairfield was 6 for 13 for just under 50%. But they made 4 out of 6 from 3. So that's essentially the difference in the game. They're getting open looks, and it doesn't look like they're outlandish shots for them. They look well within their offense, and they're doing a nice job. We did hit the 1 three-pointer, but we've only taken 3 of them. So we're 1 for 3. Free throws, Fairfield didn't shoot a free throw, and we shot 2. Hit 1 for 50%. Rebounding is 10-9 in favor of Fairfield. And turnovers is in their favor as well. They have 6 and we have 7. So a really evenly played half.
It is.
I think it was a little sloppy on our part on some of the passes and a lot of the tip balls. Maybe some of our timing was thrown off when Elijah went out early with 2 fouls. That can happen sometimes. But I look for a much better second half from both teams than what we saw in that first half.
So what are some of the adjustments that Coach Yoder is going to make in that second half, you think?
Well, if Fairfield stays in their current defense, if they come out in that 1-3-1 again, which I suspect they might because it was pretty effective, I wonder if we wouldn't go to more of a two-guard top. We started a lot with like one guy up top and 2 on the wings. And so it was easy for that lead defender out there to kind of pressure the ball and slow the reversals. And so I wonder if we go 2 up high, that might distract him a little bit, and we might get some openings and some better penetration. So I think he might be a little upset about some of the plays that we called. The guys didn't seem to know what we were called or what we were doing, or if they didn't hear him. I'm not sure what it was. But this is one of those games where, you know, a lot of our normal plays and what we get points off of aren't going to necessarily be effective. And it's just going to come down to making extra hustle plays, getting rebounds, getting steals. It's really going to start on defense because we seem to have a knack for beating them down the floor when we do get a steal.
Yeah, we do.
So I would look for that more this half, more of that this half. And I don't know, we might see a little bit of Nolan. I don't know, we didn't see him in the first
half. Well, he played JV tonight.
Oh,
he
did
played
he?
Some JV, yeah.
Okay. Well, there must be some coaching decisions, or maybe he's getting some experience down there.
He definitely has some minutes left, but he did get some JV playing time tonight,
okay.
So that's why that's probably why we haven't seen him up to this point. So.
Yep. That's a good point. So it's just going to be making the plays we can make. You know, we have nothing out of Nick. He's a big body in there. He's got the ball a few times, but they fouled him before he could get a shot up. I think all the time when you're struggling on offense, you want to try to get it down low to get things started. And I would look for that early in the half, try to get him going.
All right, Fairfield was switching up their defenses a little bit. They had a 1-3-1 to start, and that's what you're thinking they'll come back with?
It seems what they're most comfortable
with.
Yeah, they went drop back to a 2-3 later. But that seemed to really stymie our rhythm and our offense out there. And, you know, if you have wings that can just drill three-pointers, that's not a very effective defense because you got shots in the corners you get. But we seem hesitant to take those.
Yeah, we have been so far.
So they're effective right now.
Both teams have returned to their huddle now, and we're getting set for second half action. Earlier tonight, the girls were victorious 45-43 over the Lady Falcons. So Randy Yoder and his Lady Warriors improved their record to 10-9 now, 6-4 in the conference.
That's a good season for them with what they lost
you
and
bet.
The injuries they've had. And they were really young. And so that's great.
Yeah, with Summer Conkle, a key ingredient to that offense being, I guess she's pretty much out for the whole, for the rest of the year now. Talked to her after the interview with Kurt Stump. And she actually had her ankle unwrapped, and it's still pretty swollen.
Is that was it a sprain or a break?
Yeah, it's a really bad sprain.
Really bad sprain.
Yeah. Which, actually, sprains can be worse than breaks as far as healing and so on.
Yeah,
so
it's always there. Once you do it really bad, it just seems like it happens easier.
Westview inbound to begin the second half, and Elijah Hales receives the inbound pass from Josh Hostetler.
Back in the 1-3-1.
Charlie gives it to Nick.
It's kind of a conundrum out there. We need Nick in there for a big body and rebounding, but with the kind of offense we're looking to create out there, it might serve it well to have another shooter in there. But we'll ride this. He can hit that 15-footer if he's looking for it.
Once again, Josh Hostetler inbounds it. Elijah, right side to Charlotte, right back to Elijah.
One thing I think we could do better on that that top screen we're trying to set on number 10 is not working well because we're not going shoulder to shoulder and he's sneaking through there.
Good point. Long three by Elijah and he hits.
Elijah said enough of this.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking. Yeah. Okay. We've tried all that. I'm going to hit a three here. 17-16, Westview back on top. Oh, lightning fast pass into Shannon Miller from Hofer. Now a three by Willard. Long, no good. Charlie Yoder fights for it, but has it taken away by Jake Oberlin, and he puts it in.
Yeah, that's just a strength thing there. A junior, just a freshman.
Right. 18-17, Fairfield up by one. Josh Hostetler with the ball, 6:24 to go in the third quarter. Down low, on the baseline, jumper by Charlie's good.
Good to see that. The more he hits, I think the more he's gonna shoot it, and we could really use that tonight. I take that back on that last rebound. It was a freshman against a senior.
Oh, that's right. Good steal, ball knocked out of bounds, and we have a foul, actually, underneath.
That's on Stevens. Good hard foul, nothing dirty about it, but he made sure that he didn't get the ball up again, above his shoulders so he wouldn't get a three-point play. I've noticed at times 24, Miller, he seems to be, he's not lackadaisical at all because he plays really hard, but he seems to be just a little careless with the ball. And that time you saw, he's kind of slapped it out of his hands when he really wasn't looking, so.
Took advantage of it.
That's heads up play that time.
Kind of team we are. Hales hits one of two.
I got to play with his dad in some church league and pickup ball. And there,
Ross?
huh?
Ross Hales?
No,
or are you talking about Shannon Miller?
Shannon Miller,
oh, okay.
Yeah. Sorry, I should have clarified that.
That's all right.
But, yeah, they're both feisty and hard workers. And it just so happened the son's about 8 inches taller than the dad. So
really?
It's really... really benefited him. He's a nice player.
Nick Rensberger, he'll get it to Elijah up front. 20-18, Westview by two. Charlie gets it at the corner to Josh Hostetler, back to Charlie in a wing. Now Elijah with a three again. I think he's feeling it.
Yeah, we're starting to get a little more feel for it, where the openings are, and I wouldn't be surprised to see Fairfield come out of this defense after that.
Coach, Troy Beachy wants to talk it over. 23-18 Westview with the lead. 5:08 to go in the third quarter. Back in 30 seconds.
Topeka Do It Best Hardware at the Blinker Light in Topeka is your authorized Maytag, Whirlpool, and Amana dealer. Topeka Do It Best has been selling appliances and providing service to the Topeka area for over 40 years. See JJ for your appliance parts. If they're not in stock, no problem. Topeka Do It Best will have them the next business day. Topeka Do It Best Hardware provides in-store repairs, and they make house calls. If it's worth doing, do it best. Call 593-2973.
And we're back. 23-18. Westview leads it. Jamie, you made a good point. It was 23-18, the girls at halftime, with Fairfield leading. So it's just the opposite. But,
yeah.
I mean, we're a little bit further than halftime, only, what, 2 minutes and 52 seconds. But
yeah, look for Fairfield here. You know, we'll see. Maybe they'll stick with it a little longer, but they may switch defenses here, and they might be a little aggressive here on the offensive end.
Stevens gets it to Hofer, now to Willard. Willard drives the baseline, and he puts it in.
Yeah, poor defense that time by us. Our help side defender was AOL that time, or AWOL, or whatever
AWOL,
you call it.
AWOL, there you go.
AOL used to be an internet provider, I think.
Yeah, a long time ago.
And driving. We just returned the favor.
Hales puts it up off the glass and good. Really caught fire here in the second half. 13 now for Elijah. 25-20, Westview up by 5. 4.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Willard again, this time the opposite baseline, and he hits and he's fouled.
Yeah, that was late help side defense again that time.
So that'll send Brady Willard, the senior, to the free throw line, trying to complete the three-point play.
What we want to do on that help side defense there is the way our defense is structured is when the ball's in the corner, there should be a help defender on the ball side of the basket. And so when they drive, we can stop them outside of the lane, and we're not getting that done.
Willard misses his free throw, and Westview with a rebound. 25-22. The Warriors lead it by 3.
See, hey. Fairfield's in a man-to-man now.
Oh, yeah, they switch.
Which is a little unusual having Miller on Hales, but maybe they want to put a big guy on him.
He's playing way off of him because I'm sure Elijah's got that quick step. He's got the quickness. Now there's a switch. Elijah fakes, puts it up, scores.
Wow, that's a big time move right there. Great first step, ball fake, and he had to make sure he didn't charge too, so.
That's all right. 15 points now for Elijah. Ball out of bounds. It's going to stay in the hands of Fairfield.
Yeah, this is the Elijah Hales show right now.
What
did he
have?
Two at halftime or
four?
No, he had four at halftime. So he's got 11 this quarter.
Yeah, that's a pretty good quarter.
Yeah. 11 of our, what? What do we have? 14? 11 of our 13. Charlie's got the other two.
Miller, Willard, both teams putting on more of a scoring show.
Defenses are getting a little loosened up, and offenses are starting to feel it finally. So,
3-point game, Westview with the lead, 27-24, in control of the basketball. Charlie drives, has it knocked away from behind by Stevens and out of bounds.
Good drive by Charlie. It's still our ball, so we'll take that every time.
Lucas Yoder in for Rensberger. Josh Ostetler comes to the bench. Jeremiah comes in for him.
So we lose some size now, but what this may do is force Cody to take more of a rebounding role out there and get him going a little bit.
Hales inbounds to Charlie, gets a pick and takes the three and hits.
Who says we can't shoot?
6-point lead now for the Warriors after that three by Charlie. 30-24, 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. Willard for three. He misses. Rebound, Charlie.
Good box out by Charlie that time. I don't think he wanted to have another meeting with his dad.
Picks the ball up on the wing and gives out to Jeremiah Hostetler, not Elijah. Charlie drives it into the paint, gives off to Jeremiah, and he had an open shot, but it wouldn't go. Ball thrown away by Shannon Miller, pass intended for Stevens.
They had his beat back that time, but fortunately, the quarterback couldn't complete the bomb.
Over through the end zone.
Yeah, good shot that time by Jeremiah. He needs to keep shooting those, and that's going to go in 9 times out of 10.
30-24. Yeah, good shot selection. I mean, he had, what, 15-footer there?
And I think what you're starting to see is maybe why Fairfield plays a lot of different defenses, because it might not be their strength to play man-to-man.
Nice give and go to Charlie, or to Cody Collier.
Yeah, West great execution. I'm talking too much, but that's great execution that time. That's a play they put in, I think, just this year. And they've run it at select times each game. And yeah, that man-to-man's given us really good looks.
So it sure
now
is.
Now we know why they're playing 1-3-1 quite a bit. So, you know, to be really good at man-to-man, you got to almost exclusively play that and practice it nonstop. And when you don't, and you can get ahead of them a little bit, it forces them to start just trying everything. And kind of where Fairfield's at right now. So if we can keep them from getting much closer, I think we can keep scoring like this.
We've really turned it up a notch here in the third quarter, especially Elijah Hales. Charlie Yoder's come alive too.
So we've had, what, 18 this quarter?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a more normal quarter.
32-24, 2:05 to go in the third quarter. Fairfield will inbound. So you look for him to switch back when we get the ball back to a zone once we get down there?
That's a good question. I'm not sure what. They may go to some kind of trap or something to try to get us out of our rhythm a little bit.
Shannon Miller gets it to Willard. Willard out front to Munn, not a Hofer. Inside of Shannon Miller. He gets it to Willard, three, good. Willard's first three of the night. He has seven now. 32-27, Westview by five.
Yeah, it was an experienced play right there. They ran a play and they were looking for a matchup they liked and they got it.
Elijah Hales gives off to Jeremiah Hostetler. Minute and a half to go in the quarter. Now Charlie, he'll give it to Hales. Lucas, he'll pop a three. Off the back of the iron, no good. Charlie tips it out and it's picked up by Elijah Hales.
That's okay, because that was a tap-out rebound, and we never had control. So that's what Fairfield's hollering about. But
yeah, Coach Beachy wanted a over and back. Willard drives it all the way, misses the layup, gives rebound, comes down to Charlie Yoder. We have a reach-in foul. It's going to be called on Shandon Miller.
Yeah, they were going after Charlie that time because of his perceived lack of muscle, but he was really fighting in there. And gets a much bigger guy. Great rebound that time.
Third foul on Shandon Miller. He'll come out. Coming in will be Jake Oberlin.
Big possession here. It's like they're picking up full court here to try to. Good chance to get a layup here if we can break this.
Inside a minute, 52 seconds to be exact in this third quarter. Get it across the timeline there. Now to Charlie. Charlie takes it down to the baseline, and we have a whistle and another foul on Fairfield. This time it's going to be picked up by Zach Munn, the 5'11 senior.
Yeah, we didn't have our press break set up very well that time, but when you have Elijah, sometimes it doesn't matter. You just give it to him and he goes.
He was able to do it on his own. Elijah looking to inbound, still looking. And a quick timeout called by Rob Yoder before the 5-second count. It's going to be a 30-second timeout. We'll take one here too, Justin. 30 seconds, we'll be back.
Fever, sore throat, body aches. Yes, the flu season is here, so how do you protect yourself? Well, talk to the friendly pharmacists at Topeka Pharmacy about getting a flu shot. They're free with most insurance plans. No insurance? Pay $32 for the regular dose or $60 for the senior dose, and you'll receive a $5 gift card for your next visit. No appointment needed and no prescription needed for those 11 years and older. Many other immunizations are available. Call 260-593-2252 or stop by Topeka Pharmacy in downtown Topeka.
32-27, 45.6 seconds to go. Westview with the lead, third quarter. Elijah Hales will inbound.
I would think here if we don't get something quick off the inbound, we'll probably hold for one.
Elijah, he'll get it all the way out front to Jeremiah Hostetler, not a Lucas Yoder, right back to Jeremiah.
Yeah, they're back in the 1-3-1 now.
We're going to spread it out a little bit. During that timeout, assistant coach for Fairfield came over and was talking to Blaine Meeks, still arguing about the call on that over
oh,
and back.
I didn't see that. Yeah, I think it's a little gray there. I know if you tap it out on a rebound like that, backcourt, it's okay. The thing is, we touched it before it went backcourt, so I'm not sure.
Oh, that's right.
I don't know if you have to have possession there or what the deal is, but.
Yeah, we didn't grab it or anything and lose it
right
into the backcourt. 8 seconds. Josh Osteller shoot a three, and he hits from the corner.
Perfect.
Second three of the night for Josh. Last second shot goes up and hits the standard holding the basket up. So Westview pulls out to an 8-point lead now at the end of three quarters. 35-27 over Fairfield. We'll be back with fourth quarter action right after this.
The Hometown Treasurer has been covering the Topeka, Shipshawana communities and the Westview schools for over 14 years. Keep up to date on area and school activities. The Hometown Treasurer is a monthly publication published by LaGuana Printing, featuring full-color photos and news from all six schools in the Westview school system. Also, articles written by local writers, as well as games and contests for children and adults alike. Pick up our latest issue on newsstands or check us out on Facebook or visit our website at the hometowntreasure.com.
Dale's Dependable Handyman Service provides handyman repairs and remodeling to the surrounding LaGrange County area, including Goshen, Middlebury, Albion, Kendallville, and Angola. If you're looking to update your kitchen, sometimes it's as simple as changing countertops and adding tile and glass backsplash. It can make your kitchen look brand new. Dale's Dependable Handyman Service, providing quality installation with quality materials. Call Dale at 260-336-9364.
So Elijah has 50. 35-27, Westview with a lead as we begin the fourth quarter. Fairfield will inbound. I was mentioning Blaine Meeks. We normally don't see a referee do a doubleheader, but he did tonight. He did the girls game, and he's back out here. Stevens just hits a three to begin this fourth quarter for Fairfield.
That's the same play they ran on the other side of the court out of their previous timeout, where they dribble one way and throw it over a skip pass, and nailed it both times. Fairfield's threes are keeping him in the game, or is it, this
they
thing
would
be close to over by now.
Josh Osteller finished the third quarter with a three. Westview has, what, three threes? Charlie Yoder.
Charlie's got one. Josh has two, and Elijah has two. So I think we got.
Yeah, we have five.
Somebody's not putting the threes up on the wall.
Yeah, what's going on here? Back door to Charlie, and it's slapped away by Stevens.
Nice backdoor feed that time by Jeremiah. Charlie saw he was in trouble in the lane and scooted backdoor. But Stevens is a nice player. He's real heady and reactive and swatted it out of there. But
Hales once again will inbound. He get it to Lucas Yoder. Out of Hales. Hales drives it into the paint, puts it up off the glass, and good, and they held it.
Should have been an and one. He was draped on his back that time.
Stevens down the baseline.
Yeah.
Offensive foul.
Yeah, that's where the help side's supposed to be, and that's what happens if it's in position. So we did two things. They ran that same play again where they dribble and try to throw it over the top, but that time we had Elijah out there, and he snuck past the screen and stopped the shot, and then our help side defense was perfect.
Stevens picks up his second foul. 6:40 to go in the ball game. Westview by 7, 37-30. Josh, inside feed to Lucas, reverse layup.
Oh,
no good, but he'll be fouled to go to the line shooting two.
Nice job by Lucas, taking his time, giving the fake, knowing that they'd be jumping for it.
That was called on Oberlin. That's his second. Coach Yoder talking to his guards, Elijah and Charlie. And Jeremiah Hosteller doing some janitorial duties.
Isn't there supposed to be somebody doing that?
You'd think so.
Your current player?
Yeah. Yeah, really. At least somebody off the bench or something.
We know his parents must make him do that at home. Maybe it's just
sure.
A habit.
I'm sure they do. Luke misses his free throw. He'll get another. 6:33 to go in this ball game. Westview looking for a doubleheader win here tonight against the Falcons. Actually, it would be a quadruple header if you count the JV games. We won three in a row. Could make it four here.
I think Coach seems to have found kind of a lineup he likes. He's stuck with this for a while. A little bit smaller, but we're getting some good minutes out of it.
Lucas hits his second, 38-30. Foul inside as Hofer goes up for the shot. That'll be on Josh Hostetler.
Yeah, that's the downside to a small lineup. Threw a lob over the top, but.
Oh, that was Charlie that picked up the foul.
Yeah, Charlie was. He saw it coming, that they just kind of threw it a little bit higher than he could reach.
Two fouls now on Charlie tonight. At the line is Cordell Hofer. Shots up, in and out, no good. Ryan Gear checking back in. Coming out for Fairfield will be Jake Oberlin.
It may be a score someone might be interested in tonight from our conference. Fremont has beaten West Noble, 58-54.
Short on the next free throw.
That was a battle for that rebound. You can tell they're used to going to war in practice because that's what that
exactly
looked like right there. Great rebound, though. I don't think he even had the right angle, but he out-hustled the guy.
Josh Hostetler double-teamed out front, gets it out of trouble to Jeremiah Hostetler.
Yeah, they got Fairfield's kind of got their quick athletic lineup in there, really trying to get a steal out there.
Charlie Yoder, ball intercepted. Cordell Hofer stepped in and made the interception. He'll get it to Willard, back to Hofer, now to Shannon Miller. Now Willard for three. Missed it, short. Rebound, Josh Hostetler. To Charlie Yoder. Westview by eight. 5.5 minutes to go in the ball game. Elijah Hales into the lane and back out again.
Looks like they're going back to man. They just can't chase us all over the place for the next 5 minutes.
I think you're right there. Lucas Yoder, Charlie Yoder for three. It's going to be long and rebounded by Gear.
That would about put him away right there, I think, but
wouldn't go.
Oh, had a trip. Oh.
Hofer. And we've got a foul again on Josh. That'll be his second.
Quick surprise trap that time. We knocked that out of his hands, but we just couldn't corral it and then got fouled and going for it.
Oberlin will inbound for Fairfield. Charlie Yoder on him. 5:05 shows on the clock here in the Westview gym. Westview by 8, 38-30. Rensberger and Collier come to the bench. They'll come in at the next stoppage of play as Stevens pops it from the baseline right side and hits.
Yeah, he's a nice player. Nice pull up that time.
6-point lead now for the Warriors. Hales, Josh Hostetler back to Hales. Fairfield still in the man. Lob inside to Lucas. Tries to put it up, has it blocked. He'll try to put it up again. Misses a shot, but once again, he's fouled. They'll go to the free throw line shooting a pair.
Yeah, I think Coach likes those shots okay, even though the average fan might think they're kind of wild, but Lucas is very good at using his body to get the shot up or get fouled.
When he was on the JV, he lived down there.
I mean. Yeah, he really did. He's a forward at heart.
First shot by Lucas off the back of the iron, no good.
It's like we're bringing our big lineup back in.
Collier back in, and Rensberger will be coming in for Lucas if he hits this free throw. Shot up and good.
Lucas, good minutes that time by Lucas.
It was.
And who was it? Josh. So
got some fresh bodies in there now with Cody Collier and Nick Rensberger.
Yep, they should be raring to go.
7-point lead for the Warriors. Shandon Miller, high post right side, drives on Rensberger to put it up. Misses a shot. Rensberger with a rebound, has it knocked away. Shot up and good off the glass by Oberlin.
Another ball that we had that we just couldn't corral.
Once again, Elijah Hales breaks the pressure and he's fouled on a reach in by Willard. Was it 12 or 1? I guess he was, it was 12, I guess he got the foul. So that was Hofer picking up his third. Elijah Hales will go to the free throw line. 1-1. And he hits, he'll get it the bonus. Now for Elijah.
Those teams are kind of having it's kind of opposite of the first quarter. Now each team can't stop the other team.
That's true.
And early in the game, it was the other way around.
41-34, Westview by 7. Miller to Stevens. Stevens bounce passes it to Willard. Willard in the corner left side pulls it out. On the pass, it'll come to Oberlin. Oberlin has it knocked away by Charlie, and then he bumps him as he tries to get around him to make the steal.
Yeah, he tapped it out and thought he could go around him and get it, but was it Oberlin, 14?
Yeah.
Yeah, he used his body and shielded him off.
Picks up his third. Stevens now to Willard. Willard misses badly on that attempted three. Pulled down by Elijah Hales. Hales with Willard on him like glue. He's double teamed, gets it out of trouble to Jeremiah Hostetler. Jeremiah hands it off to Elijah, and a bump and a foul is going to be called on Stevens.
I think this is going to bode well for the end of the game. They're at 9 fouls now, or maybe that's 8. But we'll if we can hit these, and we're going to be in the double bonus here before long, and that'll really make it really tough to come back for Fairfield.
3.5 minutes, yeah.
As long as we don't turn the ball over and just take shots within the offense, we should be good.
Elijah Hales hits again. He has 20 points. 16 of those have come in the second half.
Yeah, he came out on fire and real determined this half. And just his hard work is really paying off with his scoring ability.
Shot up and good by Elijah. 43-34 now, Westview by 9. Josh back in, Rensberger out. Shandon Miller inbounding to Stevens. Stevens tries to drive the baseline. Now just put it up inside the arc. No good. Tapped around. Still loose. Picked up by Josh Hostetler. And we have a held ball.
I've never played rugby, but somehow that just seemed kind of like rugby right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, it did, didn't it?
It wasn't a travel even. They took about 4 steps. The yeah. other guy was with the ball.
What do they call that? The rock, or what do they call it in rugby? Anyway.
Scrum?
Yeah, it's a scrum once they get into where they lock arms and try to go with the ball, but yeah, I'm not sure what the ball's actually called.
Oh yeah, that's a good point.
Maybe it's a rugby ball.
I don't even know.
Josh Hostetler looking to inbound, gets it into his brother Jeremiah. He'll drive, and he's tied up underneath, and we're gonna have a traveling violation.
Wow. Yeah, he was calling timeout that time, but somehow they didn't see that.
Well, he's covered up by Fairfield players, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a tough place to get to and pick your dribble up, and that's what the coach is telling him. Don't go there. That's where they want you to go.
Yep.
So, but we couldn't get it to Elijah because they were busy mauling him on the other side. Not that I'm biased or anything.
Oh, no. Not at all. Stevens tries to drive on Elijah. He does. Pulls up too hard off the glass. And now we have a whistle. And what? Contact inside. They're going to call it on Westview, I guess.
No, I think
it's Fairfield. Yep.
Yeah, Ofer. I think he whacked him from behind when we had the ball. That's a good call.
Jake Oberlin picks up personal foul number 4. 1-1 coming for Cody Collier.
Chance to push this lead into double digits.
This would be a big win for the Warriors.
And this would be Cody's first point, wouldn't it?
No, he had a. Yeah, he had a.
Oh, he had a layup on that third quarter play they called.
That's his first free throw of the night. 10-point lead now for the Warriors. Cody, one more coming his way. And he hits. 2:55 now to go in the ball game. Westview with a pretty comfortable 11-point lead. Stevens. Whistle, contact underneath. They're going to call Josh Hostetler.
Well, one thing we kind of teach on defense is when a cutter's coming through the lane, don't give him a free ride. Help him along a little bit, so to speak. But You gotta be careful in how you do that.
They lob it into Hofer. Hostetler, now he gets it out of trouble to Oberlin. His three's off the mark, and rebound Jeremiah Hostetler to Elijah Hales.
We got four guys on Elijah, so somebody's open.
Four other guys are open. Finally, they call a foul, and that will go against, who was it? 30, I guess. Stevens picks up his fourth foul.
Yeah, it sure helps a basketball team when you got a guy that can just handle the ball against, well, pretty much the whole other team.
Yeah.
But, yeah, if he'd have looked up that time, I think he would have probably fired one down court and had a layup.
Yeah, he could have pretty much thrown that one blindly. Somebody would have come up with it.
Had a pretty good chance of being completed.
Like a Hail Mary. 22 now for Elijah as he hits his first free throw.
Not sure how many of our last points have been free throws. It seems like
a bunch.
Yeah, 8 or 9 in a row maybe.
That one misses. 46-34, 12-point lead for the Warriors. Hofer gets it to Oberlin. Now to Stevens in the corner, drives the baseline, puts it up, scores, and he's fouled.
Yep, that's just a little inexperience that time with Charlie. He was the better that time on help side, but if you're going to foul him, you got to make sure he doesn't get the ball up.
Gear back in the ball game. Munn will come in also, and who else? Somebody for the shooter. I can't see his number.
Something too, I think. 32, maybe? No.
22.
Who's not on the roster?
Another mystery man. Charlie, by the way, picked up his fourth foul. Stevens at the stripe. And he hits. His 10th point tonight. Or 12th. 12th point. According to the scoreboard.
Yeah, important possession here. You want to get it down under 2 minutes with a lead like this. And they're picking up full court again.
Jeremiah finally lobs it into Charlie, but it's intercepted by Hofer, not a Willard. Willard shoots, misses a three-pointer. Elijah Hales is fouled just beyond the midcourt stripe as he's pretty much grabbed by Willard. So,
yeah, that's one you wish they'd let go. That, or it should have been intentional.
Well,
I mean,
yeah,
when you're grabbing somebody
grab
from
him.
Behind, you're, I know in the NBA that's considered intentional. It's obstructing a clear path to the basket, but don't think they're going to go by NBA rules tonight.
Probably not. A few steps away. Short on the free throw, and the first one for Elijah.
Yeah, a lead can evaporate quickly. You start turning it over and missing free throws, and next thing you know, it's a three-point game. So need to get back on track here and drill this one.
Fairfield has been missing a lot of their three-pointers, especially here in the second half.
Yeah, and I wondered if that would happen. You know, that's the only reason they were in the game. As soon as you start missing them.
Yeah, they're just not falling. Well, I think you mentioned that there's a lid on this basket in the first half. Maybe you're right.
Good point. Working the other way this half.
Yeah. Elijah once again will key it up at the free throw line. He misses again, two in a row, and now we have another foul. They're going to call that on Hofer.
I didn't see that, but I'm glad somebody did.
Hofer picks up his fourth, and that will send Cody Collier to the free throw line, shooting two. Right? Are we in a double bonus now?
Yeah, we're in a double bonus.
Nothing but net for Cody.
Nice shot by Cody. I think we would miss three in a row there.
Yeah, we did.
And that can sometimes become contagious. So Elijah rarely shows emotion, but you can tell he's kind of disgusted with himself.
Misses the second.
So one of our last five.
Hofer with the ball left side. He'll give off to Shandon Miller. Now to Stevens. Another three in the air. It's way off the mark by Oberlin. Josh Ostetler pulls it out of there, but he's mugged. And
well, I'm not sure how there wasn't a foul there. My goodness.
Yeah, another scrum. Elijah Hales ended up on the bottom of the heap with three Falcons on top of him.
I think what Rob's telling Josh out there is grab the ball and just get strong. We're trying to grab it and run with it right away. We're running into trouble, and that's why they're not calling the foul, and that's why we're getting turnovers.
Making sure that the wet spots on the floor from the perspiration from the players is wiped up.
You know, the first quarter was hard for the crowd to get in the game because there wasn't any scoring, and now because all these free throws, we're kind of in the same.
Yeah, it's really quiet.
Same boat.
Now they're wiping off the basketball. I guess it's too warm for January. Everybody's really sweating out there tonight. Luke Stevens inbounding for Fairfield. Gets it into Oberlin. Back to Stevens. A quick three is no good. Rebound skying for it was Cody Collier, and he got fouled from behind. I think Willard came in there trying to poke the ball away. Nope, it was called on Chandon Miller, his fourth.
Yeah, Fairfield's getting decent looks at three, but they're not uncontested. We're really in their face, and they're having to take really tough shots. So Elijah, in addition to leading us in scoring, is guarding their best player. So that's just another great effort tonight by him.
Is. Collier's free throw, good again. Cody with six. 48-37, Westview by 11. Second shot, no good. The rebound comes down to Jake Oberlin. He'll get it to Stevens.
Still in the game.
Now Willard drives, gives off to Oberlin. Oberlin passes up the three, drives it, puts it up. Too hard off the glass, and the rebound comes down to Charlie Yoder. And he's fouled. Wow.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my goodness, yeah. Looked like they tried to tackle him. I'm usually pretty fair with the officials, but boy.
Oh, they overruled it. Yeah. They did call a foul.
Yeah. That's the correct call.
Yeah. They hit him high and low, and I think the one ref didn't see the high, but the guy from behind did.
That's five on Oberlin, so he'll have to come out.
Our Fairfield brethren are protesting the overrule, but they know it's the right call. It was right in front of them, and Charlie was getting bounced around down there like a tennis ball.
So Oberlin comes to the bench. Charlie Yoder goes to the free throw line.
That's some measure of revenge there for Charlie. He's got the best of Charlie a couple of times, but Charlie's still in the game, and we're winning, and Oberlin's on the bench.
Charlie hits his first free throw of the night. First opportunity from the free throw line for Charlie, I think.
Yeah, I believe it is. He's got 10 now.
Misses that one. Stevens grabs it. Minute and a half to go in the ball game. Westview up by 12. All the way to the bucket. Stevens can't spin it in, and we have a tie up underneath. Maybe a foul's called.
Yeah, I called one on Jeremiah.
Looks like Jeremiah. One. That'll be his first.
The sixth or the seventh? Yep, that's the seventh, so it's 1-1.
That'll send Hofer, 6'2", sophomore Cordell Hofer, to the free throw line. Minute and 23 seconds now to go.
Yeah, this is if we can hang on here, this will be a nice win. I hate to talk about it with a minute 23 to go, but Fairfield's a really good team. They got good players, and they're really talented.
Another shot there. Nice pass down court, but Charlie can't find the handle. Goes out of bounds. Last touch by Fairfield, so it'll stay in the possession of the Warriors. We're going to have to come right back out here tomorrow night.
Yeah.
Play Garrett.
That's always a little bit tough. You put a lot of emotion into the Fairfield game, and then you come back. It's just you just can't get up the same for every game. It's just not physically possible.
An immediate foul on the inbound pass. So.
Yeah, if we'd be hitting our free throws, we'd have about a 15-point lead right now, or bigger than that. I think we're three for our last eight.
Yeah, this would be a true blowaway.
Yeah, it'd be over. But on the other end, Fairfield's not converting, so we're getting away with it.
Yeah, they're missing. Elijah hits that one. 23 now for Elijah. Garrett is 4-10. Let's see, did they play tonight? 20th. Let's see. Doesn't look like they were in action.
Okay.
Elijah hits his free throw.
No doubt they're here, be my guess. Watching.
Yep, they probably are. Willard inside, misses a shot. Rebound Charlie Yoder once again.
That'll be ours.
Alternating possession. It will belong to Westview.
That was a great rebound by Charlie. He went up. I think there was three guys in there. He went in there and just grabbed it.
Munn and Gear come back in. Stevens comes to the bench along with Miller. 59.2 seconds to go in this one. Westview with a big lead and the basketball.
It's been a while, that's for sure.
Long time since Fairfield's put one in the hole.
They've missed three layups. They've missed several threes.
Jeremiah will go to the line after getting fouled out there. So he'll be shooting two on the double bonus. So, yeah, Garrett will come in here tomorrow night. 4-10, 2-3 in the conference. With the new basketball coach.
Did they name someone permanently, or is it interim?
I think it's the interim coach, yeah.
Yeah. Do you know who it is?
Can't think of his name.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that could, you know, they weren't doing very well, so that could change things around for him, give him a little new outlook. Two more missed free throws. Wow.
51-30. Yeah, we'd have over 60 points, I think. But ball knocked away, but into the hands of Miller. He looks for the shot, can't find it. Then he tries to drive toward the basket, and somebody got a hand in there. I'm not sure which of the Warriors committed the foul. And it's going to be Jeremiah Postetler picking up his second.
Yeah, I think coach wants to not foul, just keep the clock running.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 43.4 seconds. Yeah, we don't want them scoring without the time running off the clock.
Yeah, even if they would score on that, unless they call timeout, the clock's going to run for a good 5-6 seconds even before we have to inbound it.
Sure.
But
Miller with his 10th point tonight.
Jeremiah's been hit. He's jumped into a lot of forays down in there tonight, a lot of scrums.
Yeah, he is.
He hasn't got a lot to show for it point-wise, but he's played a nice game.
He's a hustler.
I'd like to see us set up a little higher on this screen. Gives us a little more room. You'd like to see him set up about free throw line. That way you have a little room to run toward the ball. And we're setting up with about 10 feet out, and it's just, you don't want to try to hand it to them because they'll call that.
Right.
But it's not giving us a room for a good angle and a pass.
So we got a timeout called by Westview. It's going to be a full timeout.
Well, that might help clear the stands a little bit.
Yeah, I wouldn't doubt it. Got a couple text messages from Thad Hart, and I think he had an answer. He just had some information about the former coach. Gotten a little bit of trouble down at Indianapolis, so that's why they have a new coach.
Right, yeah.
I had seen that in the paper. But I don't know who their new coach is. I saw his name, but I can't remember.
Yeah, Garrett, from what I understand, since they've come back in the conference, they've tried to set up something down at Indy. I guess when they were not in the NECC for a while, they would play a football game at Lucas Oil Stadium down there. They would get like the whole conference to go down there and just play the whole day.
Wow.
And so they tried to set that up with the NECC, and they really don't have any takers with basketball. And so, but they played Central Noble down there that night.
Yeah, I saw where they played.
I don't know who else went down there, but
Lob pass comes in. Josh Hostetler grabs it. Gets it across the timeline before getting fouled. 41.2 seconds.
I would think this might be the last foul they give. I mean, generally a coach is going to play as hard as he can, but when you get down under 30, 40 seconds, there's a double-digit lead. I mean.
Well, five of his players have four fouls, so it's going to be. Might be out of players before this is over.
Yeah, he's rotating in. We're liable to see some more players that we don't know their numbers.
Probably. Josh hits both his free throws. He has eight now, or nine actually. Miller, his shot's no good from three-point range, but we have a foul underneath.
I think they're getting Josh for that one.
Really? We'll go on Josh. That'll be his fourth.
Yeah, he did. He kind of grabbed the guy's arm as he was boxing him out, and Rob's just motioning to him over, you know, elbows out, but don't reach around and grab him.
Hofer at the stripe. 1-1. One foul away from the double bonus. Hofer's free throw's way short. Picked up by Miller. He puts it up, misses. Stevens with the rebound. He'll put it up and be fouled, so they'll be shooting two more free throws.
Boy, they can't buy a basket.
No, they can't. Either from the free throw line or the field.
This will probably keep it in play, too. If he makes both these, they'll probably foul again. Not great for TV viewing, but we'll take a win.
That's right, whatever it takes.
I think he's out now. Yeah, that's five on him.
Oh, Josh is done, yep. Gets a good hand from the Westview contingent.
He really had two big threes there. One at the end of the first half, and I think he had one there in the third quarter.
Right at the end of the quarter, he hit from the corner.
Yeah. And really gave us a lift and kind of got us going. So
Stevens hits his first.
In that household tonight, they could have a debate on who had the better game tonight between him and Jeremiah.
There you go. Stevens hits again.
See, he's got, they don't even have him in the game right now on the scoreboard.
14. Well, they're probably as mixed up as we were at first. Timeout's called by Westview as Jeremiah was having trouble getting it in, finding somebody to pass to. So, yeah, this last minute of the game's taken about 5 hours.
This is like watching the NBA Finals. The end of the game when you see at the bottom of the screen and it says this team has five timeouts left and this team has six.
Yeah.
You're like, oh, boy, it's going to take a while.
Yeah. So is that no, that's a 30 because they're standing up. I guess we'll keep it here.
Yeah, I think it's pretty safe to call. Big win. You're right.
Man.
It gets us to nine wins. It's over a rival. It's over a good team. It puts us a notch higher in the conference standings. And
we were right with them in the conference.
We're what?
We're right with. I mean, we're tied.
Tied
4-1 in the conference.
Okay.
Yeah, so. Yep. That puts us a game ahead of them.
Still got a shot at it. Angola's going to have to lose a couple times to win it, but.
And they get it to Collier. Cody puts it up, scores, no foul. On the breakaway.
And that should finally finish it.
Stevens bombs away, misses. Put back is no good. Rebound, Charlie. Yoder ahead to Hales, and he'll back it out. Classy move by Elijah. 5 seconds. And that's going to do it. A huge win for the Westview Warriors tonight. Both these games, the girls first, and now the boys pick up wins against big conference opponents, Fairfield. 55-41 was their final score in this one. Westview defeating Fairfield. We'll be back to talk about scoring and wrap it up right after this timeout.
When you're turning your house into a home, your furniture plays a big part in the finished product. And you'll love the finished products at Weaver Furniture Sales in Shipshawana. Come see the Weaver family. They'll work with you to find a piece that meets your needs or have it custom built just for you.
Weaver Furniture Sales is located just south of 5 and 20 in Shipshawana. Or visit their website at weaverfurnituresales.com.
Fever, sore throat, body aches? Yes, the flu season is here, so how do you protect yourself? Well, talk to the friendly pharmacists at Topeka Pharmacy about getting a flu shot. They're free with most insurance plans. No insurance? Pay $32 for the regular dose or $60 for the senior dose, and you'll receive a $5 gift card for your next visit. No appointment needed and no prescription needed for those 11 years and older. Many other immunizations are available. Call 260-593-2252 or stop by Topeka Pharmacy in downtown Topeka.
Dale's Dependable Handyman Service provides handyman repairs and remodeling to the surrounding LaGrange County area, including Goshen, Middlebury, Albion, Kendallville, and Angola. If you're looking to update your kitchen, sometimes it's as simple as changing countertops and adding tile and glass backsplash. It can make your kitchen look brand new. Dale's Dependable Handyman Service, providing quality installation with quality materials. Call Dale at 260-336-9364.
And we're back at Westview High School. It's a very successful night for the JV program at Westview and the varsity programs. Both the girls and the boys won all their games tonight for Westview. JV defeated their opponent, Fairfield, earlier tonight in the first games here in both gyms. And the girls varsity won, and then the boys came through with a victory tonight. And Jamie, you've got the scoring rundown for this boys game.
Yep, sure do. Brady Willard, number 10 for Fairfield, ended up with 7 points. He had 2 field goals and a three-pointer. Luke Stevens, their leading scorer, who is averaging 18. He did end up with 14, but I think they were really hard-earned, and we held him down pretty well. Cordell Hoffer ended up with 2 points. First basket of the game was his only basket, so he missed a few free throws there that could have got him a few more. Jake Oberlin fouled out but ended up with 7 points with 2 field goals and a three-pointer. And Shandon Miller rounded out the scoring with 11. He had 3 threes, and I believe those were all in the first half. And then he ended up with 2 free throws for a total of 11, and they're 41. So we held them in the second half. They had 16 at halftime, and then they scored 27 in the second half. For Westview, we were led in scoring tonight by our leading scorer for the season, Elijah Hales. He's averaging 17. He had 24 points tonight, 8 free throws, 5 field goals, and then 2 three-point field goals. And he really dominated the third quarter. Charlie pitched in with 12. He had a three-pointer, a free throw, and 4 field goals. Cody got off to a little bit of a slow start, but ended up with 8 points with 4 free throws and 2 field goals. Josh Hosteller added 9 points. He had 2 threes and 3 free throws. And Lucas Yoder rounded out the scoring with 2 points, had 2 free throws. I think he was 2 for 4. So we made 18 free throws. I don't have the stats on how many we shot. I'm guessing around 26 or 28. We missed quite a few there in the fourth quarter, but we got a lead. And I thought if we got a lead that their defense wouldn't be able to take it from us and get it back. And to our credit, we didn't turn it over, and we took good shots, and we made the plays, and that shows some experience and maturity.
That's right. So, looks like we've made a step in the right direction here tonight after the bounce-back win after losing to Angola in that NACC and having the time off. We might have been a little bit rusty with some ball handling and stuff, but, boy, to pick up a win against Fairfield, that second half we really turned it up.
Yeah, we really did. Elijah came out after having to sit out a good part of the first half, and he just said, I'm going to do it. And he started hit a couple threes and then started driving, and that loosened things up. And once we got a 6-7-8-point lead, we really got confident, and they had a hard time stopping us. So. Well, great win.
Yeah, sometimes you just have to have a guy step up like that, and Elijah kind of took control in that second half and set the tone for that win for the Westview Warriors tonight. So the Warriors now go to 9-5 overall and 5-1 in the Northeast Corner Conference. Fairfield drops to 7-5 and 4-2 in the NECC. Fairfield, I think they host West Noble next Friday. Of course, we play tomorrow night. It's homecoming, by the way, here at Westview. Tomorrow night is we'll host the Garrett Railroaders. So we hope you can come out for the game. If you can't make it in person, make sure you join us here on LaGuanaMedia.com. And, Jamie, good luck in your game tomorrow.
Yeah, if anybody out there wants something to do on Saturday, the 7th and 8th grade are in the Final Four of our it's kind of our sectional. Mm-hmm. It's the conference tournament, the Land O'Lakes Conference. And it's at Central Noble. The 7th grade plays at 9. The 8th grade will play after them. And then if we win, we'll play in championship games afterward. So the 8th grade's had a good season. We're, I think, 14-5 right now.
Good.
And so we've shown good improvement and looking to have some tough games tomorrow, but hopefully we can come out on top.
Well, so, good luck.
Thank you.
So that'll do it for tonight. Once again, the final scores here tonight. The Westview girls defeated the Fairfield Lady Falcons by a score of 45-43 in game one. And in game two, the Westview Warriors boys team defeated the Fairfield Falcons 55-41. Glad you could join us tonight. For our camera operator, Matthew Beiler, our engineer, Justin Geigley, color commentator, Jamie Miller, this is Jerry Hostetler. Good night, everybody.
Today's streaming broadcast of Westview Warrior Basketball at LaGuanaMedia.com has been made possible by the following gold sponsors: Height Auto Body, Shipshe Service, Riegsecker Marketplace, and LaGuana. Silver sponsors were Yoder Insurance, Mercury Wireless, The Hometown Treasure, Quality Floor, Emma Warehouse, Fast Lane Subway, Troyer Saddlery, Frontline Auto Tech, Yoder Shipshewana Hardware, Tiffany's Restaurant, Topeka Pharmacy, Weaver Furniture, Topeka Do It Best Hardware, Jerry Standard, Yoder Popcorn, Mike's Automotive Service, Fruit May Funeral Home, and the Brethren Retreat Center. Our individual sponsors have been Tim and Donna Height, John and Leslie Cook, Dan and Don Beiler, and Jim and Liz Stump. See the schedule on our website for our next streamcast of Westview Warrior Basketball at LaGuanaMedia.com.